garden tour here. Check out everything that we have. Come on out and look right down here. Look down, you see that we have some chamomile growing. And those were just little guys. And these end up, you know, I can use these for tea, sleepy time tea. And, you know, good night, lady. That's exactly what it is. And you didn't see these guys before. We planted a bunch of, what are those things called, Lovey?
Collards.
Yeah, collards. They didn't look good. They were frumpy for like the first 2 weeks, and now they love it here. So the roses are doing really well, the knockout roses, some more collards. Isn't that a beautiful rose? Look at you. Christmas palm. Looks a little brown, but he's also a little green. We're hopeful. Come on over this way. Take a walk through. Still got the black and half mask. That's for Edward Sutton. And the bed over here looks a little weedy. That's because it is. But also, we have some, if you look down here, we have beauty berries growing on the beauty berry plant. Isn't that nice? And we have the crotons going. And if you pan over the whole area here, you can see that everybody is growing really nice. And you really got to see these guys, because we got these guys at Rock Garden when they were probably about this size right here. And they are just going crazy. They're huge. And we have three different spots where they're growing. One here, one over here. And the cattail ferns are doing nice, especially like the grass. And I think Dad might have had something to do with transplanting some of these guys. The crotons are doing really nice. Watch your step over here. There you go. Got this at the show, the Picasso. You can see that's got those crazy colors in it. And this guy's dying for a trellis. You can tell he wants a trellis. This is the regular raspberry. And then we have the golden. Looks like we might have some berries. Some fruit starting to come out of this guy. Yellow raspberry, golden raspberries. But out of six of them, we only have two growing. This is our persimmon, and we're going to have to stake him again. But look how green. That was a stick. Remember how that guy was? Nothing but a stick, and now he's getting whipped around here. The olive tree, you can see that thing's taking a beating too. Got nice fresh, all the nice fresh greens on here. The leaves are all really nice. It keeps growing. We're happy with it. And take a look along the side. Show them the berry, the 50 feet just about of trench we opened up, not trench, but we opened it up and did all of our gardening in there and put some mulch down, and we got goji berry there. And that's looking a lot better and a lot healthier. So is this guy. Looks a lot better. And then this guy, he's in need of a trellis too. Look, he's on his way over to the hose bib. He needs a trellis to climb up on. And if we could just get somebody to build one, it would be amazing. And over here, we had to restake this guy. This is the avocado. There's some discoloration here, but we're hopeful because these leaves are also a bunch of new leaves, and there's a lot of fresh green trunk on here as the leaf falls off. And you know, we're having some struggles out here, but overall, everything's looking pretty nice. You know, the orange tree, we have somebody eating them. On it yet, but there's a lot of nice green coloration here. And for once, finally, we have a papaya that looks like it wants to be a papaya tree. Now you can see next to me that it's like up to here, and I'm not the tallest guy, but we have all this nice fresh leaves coming out, and the stalk is getting green in the middle, which means that it's shooting upward. We're happy about that. And you can see that we mulched around everybody here. If you looked all the way back, you can see that we mulched every one of these trees. Thank you very much, Tim and Holly. Our mango. You remember that little brown mango? Well, this isn't it. This is a different one. This is the one that we got when we got the avocado. And it is just looking off. It's taller than me, which isn't a big feat of anything, but it's big and it's healthy and it's green, and we're hopeful that it grows. You may remember this guy too, the pomegranate. Pomegranate, put all these nice leaves in here, Lovey. See that? All these are looking kind of good. We have some brown spots, which may mean overwatering, but we have new growth in a lot of areas. We had to stake it because it was really getting whooped around. And you're going to know these guys, Figueroa. This is the one that we had. I don't know if that was Figueroa or Fig Newton, but that's the first one that we had, and you can see that it's doing well. Look at you down here. And over here, I think Figueroa is yours. And he was moved over closer to the where the tree was. All these new growths down here. And look at you, huh? Who's got a fig? We got to show him the plantain. Because the plantain was nothing but a brown leaf hanging off of this guy. Now you can see there's a sucker growing up out of here. And this thing just loves it where it's at. And this is probably the full site now. We have we moved the hibiscus out because it was doing nothing but falling inside the pool. And you can see that it has a nice amount of flowers on it. We have to repot it because you can see the top of it is nothing but roots. So we're going to have to get a bigger pot and put that guy in so he gets fed. We have actual ginger, store-bought ginger, that is in there, and turmeric. And this is actually turmeric over here. You can see right there and right there is turmeric not growing. But this is some kind of ginger that we like. These are also gingers, and we're hopeful that they grow. This guy here, this is a candelabra plant. I want to show you inside here. This thing is huge. This is all we had. Can you see that branch? That's all we had at the beginning of spring. And this thing is huge. Look at it. Every day we come out, there's more of these guys. They're going to accordion out. See, they're going to fan out. They're going to fan out. That's a leaf cluster that's going to open up. And, ooh, it looks like they're going to flower. No, that's more leaf cluster, it looks like. And it just keeps getting bigger and bigger. It's huge. Another butterfly plant, coral plant, looks like that's gone to seed. We have to read up and find out what we have to do. We keep the papyrus wet because it likes to have wet feet, and it's in very dry soil. But as you can see, we have the hose out here, and this little guy is a sweet banana. I forget what kind of call it's called. It's called a namwa, and it was a little guy, and we fertilize it once a month, and it's doing really well. It likes the wet, and we give it wet. Now you may recognize over here what used to be our tree. We had an oak tree standing right here, and now it's gone. See, no more. And as you look over this way and take a shot down the aisle here, you can kind of see we opened up some regular, not raised bed garden like we had before, but this is the normal garden. We have some okra growing here, little okra, and we have some kind of green squash.
The zucchini.
Zucchini squash growing here. And at the very end of it, we have Malabar spinach that doesn't look too healthy, but not too bad, actually. Over here, we planted some sweet potatoes yesterday. These little guys, they're going to be sweet potatoes. Just right off the, you know, it grew some giant eyeballs while it was inside the cabinet, and we planted it. And we have some scallions, or...
Red onions.
And this is celery root, right?
Well... celery greens.
It's very nice. It looks good. And you can see how dark this is the other traveler palm. That's coming back really nice. These guys are such a great color. Pay no attention to the munching going on here. But look at the deep rich colors and the thick green. It's beautiful. I can't believe how good it's coming. We have some colored chard over here. They're making it all right. And some of the squash that we planted doesn't look so good, but it's, you know, it's a gamble here in Central Florida. You don't know what's going to make it, what's not. Triangle palm. But there's always a new guy shooting up out of the middle. This guy right here was like him. Two weeks ago, this was him, and he just shot out and opened up. It was like a big sword came out, and then all of a sudden, whoop, he opened up, and he really loves it here. See, we have some beans over here. We got a big bowl of beans that we're going to eat later that we picked out of here. Another traveler palm. And if you page over here, you can see we have the other garden. And this is stuff that we rescued from our mulch, or not the mulch pile, but the compost pile, stuff that was growing on the compost pile. We replanted it. It's funny how it's taken. Have some more basil, okra, and down here we have peppers. Looks like we got some peppers, and three different kinds of eggplants are going to be growing up out of here. I can't wait till they grow out. We seem to have a pretty good luck with eggplants here. We had a Chinese eggplant that we grew, and it just kept giving and giving. Our pineapples that we had are finally standing up and shooting out. And this guy over here has, it looks like he has little babies growing in here, coming out the side. You see this guy? He has new ones shooting out of there. One, two, right now. You see that? Those are new growths coming out of there. So we're hopeful for this guy too. And we started a couple new ones on the other side. We still have some good luck with some of the herbs in here are hanging tight. We have some thyme and rosemary that's hanging tight. And of course, the pergola. This is what you see when you come around the corner. And the good thing is, when you're underneath here, you get all the shade. And it's so much nicer than being out here. I mean, it's a windy day, but in a normal, non-windy day, when you step into this checkerboard right here, it's so much cooler. And cooler in so many ways. Looks like the bay leaf tree. Allspice.
Yeah.
If you were to smell these leaves, it smells like a allspice shaker that you buy from the market. And these guys, we have to pull these out so you can see them a little bit. We started them in our kitchen. You eat a pineapple, and maybe we'll do a video on that later. Show you how to start a pineapple. But those are growing where they're at. The soil looks a little dry. That's not too bad, actually. It's clumping pretty good.
Get that part out if you want.
There's a good tomato over there. Yum. Look at you. We have more collards. We have baby papayas growing. Basil's everywhere. And this is a blueberry that, pay attention to this up here. This is new growth up here. So we transplanted the blueberry. You may recognize that guy. We have the collard. This is a tomatilla. That's probably going to need some help. You know, can we get a trellis guy in the house? These guys are just, you know, dying to get helped and supported. And as we come around the side, we're coming down to the end of the tour here. This guy's looking pretty good. There's always a lot of stuff on the starfruit tree that brand new growth everywhere. We're trying not to keep it a wet foot because the starfruit doesn't like a wet foot, and it also doesn't like to be dry, so you kind of have to like dial it in yourself. Am I watering it enough or not enough? And I found that watering it every now and then and not over watering it when you do is a good idea. So we had to move pay no attention, our plumber did this for us. Yeah, a little muriatic acid. We moved our date palm because he was having some issues, so we put him in the sun. Royal palm used to be there. Look at the size of this rosemary bush. This thing is really taking off. It's amazing. Just to give you some scale, this thing is amazing. And wow, it's really plenty too. And you may remember this guy down here. You have the almond tree. Now look at this almond tree. Isn't this nice? It has no support on it. We have some purple basil that got freshly planted around it. And just a strong tree. This thing is really going to do well with my knowledge. The Georgie plant, look at this. This guy, he could use a trimming, but I'm going to do like they tell you to do. You let them fall off when they get to 3 o'clock. And this guy looks like he's banging on 3 o'clock pretty close. This guy just shot out of here recently, and it's beautiful. You can see that color is that dark greenish, grayish, bluish. I don't know what to call it, but this guy is sneaking out behind him. He's coming up soon. We're happy to see that and all the nice flowers the lovey put in there. They look like they were gonna die, but it also looks like they're coming back to life too. On the other side, we got the European fan. This guy's indestructible. Believe it or not, this guy is how old? 10 years old already?
Something like that,
Something like that. We bought it, and it was supposed to have 10 years on it, and it's growing just like that. Lovely plant. There's always little guys that you have to trim out around it. And I'm not sure what this is called, bamboo-looking guy, because of the way the leaves peel off it. It kind of makes it look like it's bamboo. And look at this. We have some flowering and fruiting going on, which is nice. It's very windy up here, but I don't really worry about that because it seems to always shoot out new leaves all the time. There's always, like over here on this guy, we have a new one shooting out. So these are what they're supposed to do. We have some cocoa plums over here that Jake and I planted. You might remember these guys, Jake. So they're looking like they're hanging in pretty good. They're... I don't see any fruit on them yet, but I also don't see anything bad with them. The color looks good, and everything else looks good. So I hope you enjoyed the tour. We're ready to wrap up. That's another day out here, Palm Bay style.